Nobody was expecting this. And certainly not in 2000 when Miss India Priyanka Chopra, all of 18 and, was crowned Miss World. At the time, Priyanka wanted to become a clinical psychologist to understand why people turned demented. She also thought and said that India was home to 2 billion people. It wasn't. We're at 1.2 billion today. And most mortifying of all, when asked, "Who do you consider to be the most successful woman living today and why?" she answered, "Mother Teresa." Mother Teresa had died 3 years before. What followed was incredulity and fury. "We Indians send out some bimbo and she returns with the prize. And we act like we've conquered the world," Kushwant Singh wrote. "This one is singularly stupid." An editorial in the Hindustan Times said that perhaps Ms. Chopra had taken the convent school line about the Holy Ghost a little too seriously. The Indian Express headline was thus: "India breasts tape again in the world's great bimbo race." But the bimbo has come a long way since. And in the last decade and a half, she'd been no stranger to criticism. Just last year, her Reddit AMA Ask Me Anything, in which Reddit users get to interact with celebrities, backfired on her. She was attacked for her accent, auto-tuning her music, endorsing fairness creams, and for a road being named after her late father. But it is almost impressive at how unfazed she is. She coolly tells me, "I'm not running for president. Everybody's opinion doesn't matter. Haters gonna hate and potatoes gonna potate. What are you gonna do?" This interview was conducted on the phone, since Priyanka is in Montreal shooting for Quantico, the new American TV show in which she plays Alex Parrish, an FBI trainee accused of plotting the most devastating terrorist attack on New York since 9/11. Alex is half Indian and has spent 10 years in India, which explains her halfway there American accent. "I had to learn the accent. I have a dialect coach on set with me and she listens to all my lines every day, and it's quite a task," says Priyanka. The very first scene shows rubble, and amidst it, the wrist with a black bracelet wrapped around it. On it, a metal OM. "This is Alex Parrish. The show begins with an OM because I wanted it for good luck," Priyanka says. On September 27, October 3 in India, the show opened to a mostly good response. It rated a 7.6 on MB and a 7.8 on TV.com. The New York Times said she was the strongest human asset on the show, and Vulture said she very compelling on screen. Salon called her character the Indian American heroine I've been waiting for. "I've just come back to the set," Priyanka says. "I'm going to walk in for the first time after the premiere. We're shooting 9 scenes. It's going to be a long day. I'm promoting and shooting together. I don't think I could have been prepared for the hours that we do." A few minutes later, the call drops. When we reconnect, I hear excited chatter. I imagine the frenzy of people who, if all goes well and the show is renewed for more seasons, will work together for 6 months every year for many years. We're all away from home, so the cast has become very close. We meet every weekend, despite spending 15 hours a day together, especially the girls. In the beginning, Chopra's career didn't sound very promising. At best, there were some average Akshay Kumar stars, like Andaz and Atreyas, but most were forgettable. The hero, love story of a spy plan. And then came the hits one after the other. Kaarish and Da 2006, Fashion and Dastana 2008, Komini 2009, 7 Kun Maaf and Da 2011, Yipathi and Barfi 2012, Kaarish 3, 2013, Gundi E and Mary Come 2014, and the upcoming Bajirao Mastani is already making waves. There were misses now and then. Remember Love Story 2050. But in this long impressive list, you can forgive the flops. It was right in the middle of all this success that Priyanka began planning her international career. Coincidentally, this was also a time for some anti-Priyanka sentiment in Bollywood. 3 years ago, the press was aflame with gossip about just how unpopular she was among the Bollywood wives. But she is quite likable, says film critic Rajiv Maysand. She goes out of her way to charm the person. A lot of people find that suspicious, because they judge her based on the rumors. So it was perhaps as a consequence of the nasty gossip that Priyanka immersed herself in her work, and looked beyond Bollywood. Ask her about the vitriolic things said about her, and she says, "I don't want to dwell on any of that. I like to tell myself, it's over. And right now I want to think about the fact that my show opened to a huge premiere. I'm delighted with the support people in the audience and the Hindi film industry have given me." The downside of interviewing Priyanka Chopra is that she, like so many in Bollywood, tends to talk in platitudes. Working on the show has been a wonderful experience. ABC is the front runner when it comes to doing different kinds of shows. The Quantico cast is a very fun group of people. But there is some wisdom hidden in the cliched responses. Angela Okariabath, Priyanka's overseas manager, has been called the woman behind the woman because she hasn't been an ordinary manager. In 2010, Bath co-founded Deceive Hits Universal, a venture funded by the Universal Music Group to find and promote South Asian talent. Music composers Salim Sulaiman had recorded a demo with Priyanka and sent it to Okariabath. "I loved it," the manager says. "I had actually seen Priyanka and Abhishek Bachchan in Bluff Master years before. They did a song called Right Here Right Now. It was a hip-hop spoof. That's when I first had my eye on her. The other thing was her cosmopolitan looks. She doesn't look typically South Asian." Priyanka admits, "I get a lot of Puerto Rican. I guess with me doing what I'm doing now, people will realize I'm Indian." She has an international appeal, says Okariabath, adding, "It's kind of like Saeed Ali Khan. He's got a bicultural sensibility that I also think can't translate globally." Bath is responsible for all of Chopra's international ventures.